السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، الحمد لله. It's your brother Jamal Abdi Nasser from London, UK. And I'm honored to be speaking on Ramadan Radio. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our good deeds in this month. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who their good deeds are accepted and their good deeds are pleasing to Allah Azza wa Jal. And may Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala make us of those whose necks are freed from the hellfire. And I'd also like to thank the brothers and sisters at Ramadan Radio for organizing these amazing events that we are all benefiting from. These iftar shows that are being aired every single night in Ramadan, this service that they are providing the Ummah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. May Allah Azza wa Jal place it on the scale of good deeds Yawm al-Qiyamah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a means for the entry of every single one of them. Allahumma ameen. So tonight, inshaAllah ta'ala, we'd like to speak about the salah and the importance of the salah. As we know, we are in the month of Ramadan. And the month of Ramadan, the believer, he traverses to his Lord. He travels to his Lord with two wings. Two wings, if we use this expression. The first one is the janah of siyam. Janah means wing in Arabic. As-siyam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has legislated fasting during the day. And it is something which is obligatory for every single person who is able to fast. But the second janah is al-qiyam. It is the prayer, specifically the night prayer. And this night prayer is not obligatory, just like how fasting is obligatory in the day. Rather, it is highly recommended. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to us that the one who fasts in the day with iman, the one who has subscribed to this religion and this faith and this belief, he knows Allah jalla wa ala has ordained it, and he's doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he also has ihtisab, he's observing reward, he's seeking reward from his Lord. All of his sins will be forgiven. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also said that the one who stands in the night prayer with those two features as well, he has iman, she has iman, and they are observing reward from this, then all of their sins will also be forgiven. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spoke specifically about standing in a beautiful night that we are approaching. We have entered into the last 10 nights. And in these last 10 nights, firstly, they are the greatest 10 nights in the year. Secondly, they are specifically the greatest 10 nights of this month. They are the best nights of this month. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that verily actions are by their ending. So if a person, she feels that they didn't make a good start to Ramadan this year, and they didn't work as hard as they could have, then focus on these last 10 nights. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, in it is a night which is greater, not equal to, greater than 1,000 months. Whomsoever is prevented from his goodness, he has been prevented from all good. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sent down a surah in the Quran, only speaking about the virtue of this night. It is called Suratul Qadr. It's in Juz Amma. Perhaps all of you have memorized it, or have at least heard it before. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. In this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not speak about any rulings. He does not speak about any stories. All he speaks about is the virtue of this night. In other places in the Quran, he mentioned that it's a blessed night. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarak. So This night, the Prophet ﷺ said, whomsoever stands in this specific night, and he performs salah on this specific night, then all of his sins will also be forgiven. So we have just introduced the prayer, specifically Ramadan, Qiyamul Layl. We spoke about it, and Taraweeh, and Tahajjud, and so on. This juz that we are discussing tonight, the 21st juz of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he starts off this juz by speaking about the prayer. قال الله تعالى, Allah said, أتلو ما أوحي إليك من الكتاب وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. And recite what has been revealed unto you from the book of your Lord. And recite what has been revealed unto you. And establish the prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, establish the prayer. For verily, indeed, exclusively, the prayer, it does away and it removes immorality. It removes all forms of bad and evil. It gets away with it. It does away with it. It removes it and it protects the believer from these things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has made the salah obligatory. And he has made fixed appointed times for the salah. He said in the Quran, "Inna salata kanat 'ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta." This prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has made it a fixed time upon the believers. 5 daily prayers during the day and the night, every single 24 hour you have, and you have to pray and offer it at the designated time, the appointed time. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that the salah is the contract that distinguishes the believer from the disbeliever. He said, "Al ahdu alladhi baynana wa baynahum as-salah, faman tarakaha faqad kafar." He said, the contract that's between us and them, meaning the disbelievers, it is this prayer. Whomsoever leaves it off, leaves it, neglects it, abandons it, he has fallen into disbelief. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from it. This prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, it is so great that it is the only act of worship that was not legislated on the earth. It was not. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was taken on the night journey and he was ascended into the sky. And then the salah was legislated there. The salah was legislated there. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to find coolness and peace, tranquility in this salah. He would call his mu'adhin, Bilal, and he would say, "Arihna biha ya Bilal." Call the adhan, ya Bilal, so we can find comfort in this. And obviously, if you are calling the adhan, then what comes after that is the prayer. So the objective here is the prayer. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Hubbiba ilayya min dunyakum at-tibu wa nisa wa ju'ilat qurratu ayni fi salah." He said, the coolness of my eyes has been made in the prayer. This is where the coolness of my eyes is. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. We all know about Iblis. Iblis from the jinn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِ. Al-Imam Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions that Iblis was a righteous man. He was a pious man. He was given his own palace, his own virtues. Allah Jalla wa Ala, he even allowed him to remain in the company of the angels. But when Allah Jalla wa Ala, he allowed him to remain in the company of the angels and he gave him such virtue, he commanded him and the angels to prostrate to Adam. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told Iblis and he told the angels, prostrate to Adam. Allah jalla wa ala, he wanted to test them to see if they were going to follow his command. Because from the features and the attributes and the traits of the angels is that they follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. They never disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like Allah jalla wa ala, he mentions, لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. They never disobey what Allah commands. And they always do as they have been commanded. But Iblis here was the only one who did not follow the commandment of Allah. What was the commandment of Allah? for him to prostrate to Adam. He did not do it. So what happened? This destructed all of his actions that he did before. This righteous man, this pious man, this man who was given so much virtues, he was placed with the angels. Because he did not do one sajda, he became a disbeliever. And he became from the worst creation. The worst creation. And we need to ponder and ask ourselves, how many prostrations have we left? If one prostration destructed him, how many prostrations have we left? The wise, intelligent believer is the one who thinks about this. When he hears examples like this, how the people of the past, the nations of the past, the other creations and the beings that Allah Jalla wa'ala created, like the angels that we're talking about now, some of them have been destroyed because of a mukhalifa. Wahida, one mukhalifa. One thing that they did not follow from the commandments of Allah. We have to ask ourselves, how many commandments have we left? How many salahs, prayers specifically, that's what we're discussing tonight, have we left? This is something that a believer has to ask himself. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhumah, from the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he graduated from the madrasa of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His teacher was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He learned everything from him. He said, حافظوا على هؤلاء الصلوات الخمس حيث ينادى بهن فإنهن من سنن الهدى فإن الله أو إن الله شرع لنبيكم صلى الله عليه وسلم سنن الهدى. He said, preserve and protect, safeguard these five prayers. And safeguard them specifically at the places where they are being called at, meaning the masajid. For verily, these are from the teachings of guidance. These are from the teachings of guidance. And this is what your Lord has legislated to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said specifically that if you leave these prayers and you do not offer them and establish them in the masajid, and subhanAllah, look, he's not even discussing the prayer, leaving it off in general. He's discussing leaving off the prayer in the masajid for the one who's able to go. He said, if you leave this and you stay away from it, you stay away from the masjid and you perform the salah in your house, you will abandon a sunnah from the sunnan of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّةَ نَبِيِّكُمْ. You will be leaving a sunnah, a teaching, a guidance of your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَوْ تَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّةَ نَبِيِّكُمْ لَضَلَلْتُمْ. And if you leave one of the sunan of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, specifically this one, لَضَلَلْتُمْ, it will lead to your misguidance. Because in the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is all forms of goodness and all forms of guidance. And this is why Allah Jalla wa'ala, he made him our role model. He made him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam our role model. The one who finds coolness in his heart, in his eyes, as it relates to the prayer. He would say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that if a matter comes to one of you, you need a matter to be resolved, then hasten to the prayer, offer the prayer, establish the prayer. And this is the greatest act of worship. Imaduddin. This act of worship, the one who leaves it, there is no good that remains in this person's heart. Because if you have left the prayer, how can you assume that you are still upon goodness? It is not something possible. We have Luqman al-Hakim, this righteous man. An entire surah in the Quran was named after him. This man, his son, he was committing shirk and associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Jalla wa'ala, he logged the conversation Luqman had with his son. And from the advices he gave to his son, to show the importance of it, is the salah. Ya bunayya aqim as-salata wa'mur bil ma'ruf wanha 'anil munkari wasbir 'ala ma asabak inna dhalika min 'azm al-umur. Ya bunayya aqim as-salah. Oh my beloved son, establish the prayer. Oh my beloved son, who's so far away from Allah, associating partners with Allah, he is not worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants him to worship him. Oh my beloved son, establish the prayer. It is so important that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he commanded the believers, the parents, to command their children to pray the salah when they reach the age of 7. If your children reach the age of 7 and you are a parent, command them to perform the salah, to establish the salah. And he said, alayhi salatu wassalam, if they reach the age of 10, then tame them. Tame them a little bit. Do this, for they will be able to continue the salah after this. This is instilling in the child from a very young and tender age the importance of the salah. You will never see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world, but the closest you will be to Allah jalla wa ala in this world is in prostration. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he mentioned, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ. This is the closest a slave is to his Lord in this world, the prostration. And the prostration is found in the prayer. It is found in the prayer. And we have many, many other accounts and reports from the people of the past. From them is Al-Hasan al-Basri. Al-Hasan al-Basri, he's from the second generation of the Muslims, from the Tabi'in. And he's from the students of the Sahaba. The Sahaba meaning the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they are the greatest of people. The hadith has come. One of the Sahaba, he mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he looked into the hearts of all of the creation. And he found the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be the best heart, the greatest heart. So he chose him to be his prophet and he gave him his message. Then he looked at the hearts of the rest of creation and he found the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to have the best of hearts. And so he chose them to be his companions. And then this next generation who Al-Hasan al-Basri is from, he is from the students of that first generation that's the best, the companions. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also mentions that the best generation is my generation. My Sahaba, my companions, and then the ones who have come after them, and then those who have come after them. So he's from the second generation, second best Muslims. Al-Hasan al-Basri. He said, تَفَقَّدُوا الْحَلَاوَةَ فِي ثَلَاثَةِ مَوَاطِنِ. Seek and find, look for sweetness in three places. From one of those places that he mentioned, subhanAllah, is the Salah. So now we know the importance of the Salah. We know the rulings of Salah. We mentioned some virtues for the Salah. We mentioned some history of the Salah. We mentioned how the people of the past would command their children, whether or not. We mentioned the hadith specifically about commanding children, or Luqman al-Hakim, for example, who we spoke about, who also commanded his child who was non-Muslim or who was committing shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But here, on top of all of this, you're meant to establish it and stick by these salawat. And on top of that, find sweetness in it. تَفَقَّدُوا الْحَلَاوَةَ فِي ثَلَاثَةِ مَوَاطِنِ. Find sweetness in three places. And from one of those places, those three places, is the salah. Whether it is an optional prayer, whether it is an obligatory prayer. Alhamdulillah. Find sweetness in it. Because you are conversing with your Lord. You are conversing with your Lord. Al-Hasan al-Basri, the same person, he said, if you want to speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fasalli, pray the salah. You are speaking with Allah azza wa jal. And if you want Allah jalla wa ala to speak to you, then establish the salah. Read the Quran. Faqra'i al-Quran. If you read the Quran, Allah will speak to you. If you want to speak to Allah, fasalli, faqum, fasalli, pray the salah. So in this salah, my dear brothers and sisters, we are meant to find a sweetness in it. Like the Prophet ﷺ, we mentioned before, he used to find sweetness in it. And in the beginning, it may be difficult for you to find sweetness in the salah. But after time, inshaAllah ta'ala, juhud, from the verses of this 21st juz as well, the end of Surah Al-Ankabut, the final ayah, is قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Those who strive in our path. Those who strive in our paths. لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. We will guide them to our paths. They strive for our sake. We will guide them to our paths, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. So you need to strive and work hard. Think about it. If you had a worldly need and you knew only one person can facilitate it for you, whether this person is a person of authority, whether it's a king, whether it's a person who has a specific status, you know that this person is the only person who can fulfill this need of yours, and you are in dire need of it. If this person told you to come to them at 1 a.m. in the morning, come to my house at 1 a.m., I will fulfill this need of yours that you have. You will go there. You will sacrifice your sleep and your resting time, and you will leave your family, and you will make ways there, and you will travel. Because this is a need of yours, and you have yaqeen, and pay attention to what I'm saying. You have yaqeen and conviction that they are able to fulfill this for you. If when you get there at 1 a.m., they make you wait for another hour until 2 a.m., and it's now coming to the middle of the night, you will still continue to wait. If then they delay you for a third hour, you will continue to wait, because in your heart it has become filled with conviction that you are going to receive what you want, so you are going to remain patient. And this is how you should be with your Lord. Rather, you should be big, better than this and greater than this. Allah Jalla wa Ala is the one who gives you everything that you need. He'll give you everything that you ask for, everything you don't ask for. وَآتَاكُم مِّن كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ. And he gave you everything you asked. He has given you things you haven't asked for. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is saying, call upon me, I shall give you. He descends to the first heaven every single night, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, is anybody going to ask so I may give them? Is anybody going to seek forgiveness so I may forgive them? Is anybody going to repent so I may accept their repentance? So you establish this salah because in your heart, what has become filled in your heart is love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and conviction that He's your Lord and He's going to give you and grant you and bestow upon you every single thing that you require and you desire. This is the salah. This is the salah. Look at the beauty of the salah. You establish the salah. Allah Jalla wa Ala, He made it different sections. So you stand, you begin the prayer, you are standing. Allahu Akbar. You enter into it. And you start by saying, Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest. Nobody's greater than Him. And everything other than Him is less than Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. You enter into the salah. And you begin by reading Surah Al-Fatiha. And when you read Surah Al-Fatiha, after every single verse that you recite, there's a secret conversation happening between the slave and his Lord. Allah Jalla wa Ala, He replies to every single ayah that you recite, as found in the hadith. When you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah says, my slave has just praised me. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, He has spoken highly of me. Maliki Yawmiddin, He has just exalted me. So Allah Jalla wa Ala is replying to you. Then you go to ruku', you go to the bowing position. Then you stand back up. Then you go to sujood and prostration that we spoke about earlier. But this sujood and prostration, your hands and your knees and your shoulders and your feet, they are all bending and folding. So you started the prayer standing up straight. Then half of your body, when you came to prostration or bowing, sorry, it folded, the upper half of the body. Then you went to sujood and all of your body has started to fold and bend and so on. This is also Allah Jalla wa Ala showing you how He created you and how He completed His favors upon you. He subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave you 360 joints, like the hadith has come. And you see this when you are establishing the salah. So the salah is also a form of shukr, like some of the scholars they mentioned. A form of shukr, gratitude, that Allah Jalla wa Ala has made me like this. He has perfected my creation. وَصَوَّرَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. How many things has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given me? He has made me Muslim. He has created me. نِعْمَةُ الْإِيجَادِ. He has brought me to existence first. Did I ask to be created? No, I did not. Did I have a right to be created? No, I did not. He created me. Then He made me a human being. Human being. Human being. Subhanallah, He could have made me anything. He could have made me an animal, an item, an object. He made me a human being. He gave me honor. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. And we have given honor and virtue to the children of Adam, human beings. Then He made me the best human being. خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ النَّاسِ. He has made me a Muslim, a mu'min. He has made me one who is a believer and a follower of Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then after that, He directed me and invited me to stand before Him, subhanallah. The slave, he stands before his Lord two times, the scholars they say. One time is in the prayer, and another time is the meeting with Him, subhanallah, in the next life. And whosoever perfects his standing with Allah Jalla wa Ala in this world, in the salah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ease for him his standing in the next life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who give importance to the salah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who remain consistent and continuous and committed to the salah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take our lives at a time where He is pleased with us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect us all in a way which is pleasing to Him, subhanallah, subhanallah azza wa jal. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admit us into the highest jannah. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.